All right, guys, I have someone out there who is a fan of the foods that I make, and I told him that I would make what I like to call my hearty pasta. So here it is. I make ground beef along with that, and if you want to know how I cook it, I have made a separate video about that. But for this, you're going to need, I like to use whole wheat pasta, then ground beef, and the spinach, creamy vodka pasta sauce, turmeric powder, Parmesan cheese, and nutritional yeast. Sounds kind of weird, but I promise you, this thing will keep you full, and it's also pretty delicious. I would not share something if I didn't think it was good. So, you pretty much gotta calculate how long it takes for the meat to cook and then start your pasta, so that's why I still have it cooking. But it's better if you add the ingredients while it's still cooking. Yeah, so let's get into that. I like to do the pasta sauce first, so I'm going to dispense some of that and come back. Okay, if you're wondering how much sauce I did 2 teaspoons of the sauce. So first on the top, then stir it, and then the second layer, and then stir it. So yep, just try to distribute it as evenly as you can. There's going to be a lot more stirring coming up, so you don't have to worry about that. And then get our last one. Anyways, next, I like to do the spinach. And it's gonna be a little tricky because it'll want to overflow a bit, but the good thing about spinach is that it turns into nothing as it cooks. When it comes to this stage, you can see that the water is pretty much mostly dried up. That's when I like to decrease the fire a bit. And let me stir my meat. I'm gonna crank down the heat on the meat so it doesn't overcook. But anyways, yeah, you basically just wanna stir this, and I find that easier to do with a spoon. Of course, you really should be using that. But it also tends to, like, the pasta tends to get stuck in it, so I'm kind of in a hurry. So that's why I'm just doing this as I go. You can literally add as much spinach as you want to. I like to add, shoot, 1/4 pound, because if I don't, spinach is something that tends to go bad on me before I eat it all, because I just cannot eat it in salad form anymore. It's just never appetizing for me. So yeah, I would recommend that you do just that. Throw in there as much spinach as you can comfortably fit into your pot. All right, I'll keep throwing more layers of spinach in, and I'll let you know when I stop and I'll come back. Okay, so I ended up adding 2 more layers, or, well, more like 2.5. So that's why it looks pretty full, and I like that because the spinach really does give it an extra kick when it comes to the flavor. Let's add a little more. So I'll complete the 4th round. And then you just keep blending it and blending it as evenly as you can. I mean, it doesn't matter. You're going to eat all of it. And then after this, I like to add the turmeric. At this point, I personally like to get it out of the pot and transfer it onto a plate. And we can turn off the meat since I'm
ready. Are you ready? Yeah, you've been ready.
Yeah. Okay. Smells pretty amazing.
Yes, yes, yes.
So yeah, I'm pretty satisfied with the amount of spinach this has. So yeah, let's transfer it to a bowl. And you really want to use a bowl for this. Let's get this. You want to do a scoop of the pasta and then throw it on the bottom like that. And then you pretty much layer everything up. You can add as much as you please. And if you're wondering what kind of flavor nutritional yeast has, I honestly don't know what to tell you. Yeah, I don't know what to tell you. It's something that you need to try on your own and determine whether or not you like it. Honestly, I don't do it for the flavor. I do it for the nutritional benefits, as the name implies. So So we're gonna take a little pinch of the nutritional yeast and just sprinkle over it, and then some of the turmeric. That's good. Turmeric is something that if you do it in large amounts, it, at least for me, it gets me coughing. So you kind of want to be mindful about that. And then scoop some more. Let's do another one. And you really want to have a bowl that's deep and just big overall, because this thing can get messy. And then repeat. You pretty much repeat this until you're done. And of course, while doing this, you also want to do some blending as you go. For the sake of saving time on the video, I'm not going to blend it every time, because I have better control when I'm using both hands and can get it done faster. But yeah, and then once again, you get some of the nutritional yeast, and then very, very, very light on the turmeric. That's good. And then repeat. So I like to do half of the pasta, and then that's when I start introducing the meat. So to me, it just distributes better when I do it that way. And I am not very good at multitasking on the kitchen. So anyways, just bring it closer. Yep. And then you do that. And then blend it. The trick is to blend it. The more blending you do, the better off it becomes. You do that. And then if it looks plain, you add that. It doesn't have to be pretty, it's not about appearance, it's about taste and nutrition. Okay, so I'm going to finish the rest, but you saw what it's involved, and then I'll let you know what the final product looks like. So you pretty much do pasta, and then layer it with the ingredients, and then throw the meat in there, blend it, and then repeat. Okay guys, so here it is. This is the final stage of blending that I gotta do. But as you can see, this yields a lot, and I am a person who's looking for extra calories because I'm active like that. But the extra calories need to come from like actual real foods, like not just snacks that are like high in sugar or anything. Like in the mornings, I like to do something that's sweet. So lately, because I'm not trying to limit my intake of bad stuff like sugars or anything, I am having a donut every morning, but I'm just doing it for 6 days. It's because I've been kind of tight on time, so I don't have time to really make my breakfast, and I need to make a breakfast video. It's just that I haven't really had the time or chance to do it, but it's coming. I believe that you guys are going to enjoy that as well. But yep, this is it. This is my hearty pasta. I could have this every single day of my life. It's delicious. I feel great. It gives me energy. And it's pretty varied, pretty diverse. Like, I cannot go to a restaurant and order this like this. Maybe someone out there would do it, but I don't know. I feel like I have the perfect ingredients for it. Alright guys, let me know if you tried this. Let me know if it sounds good. Let me know if you would dare to try this. Let me know if you eat any of the ingredients present here regularly. Like, I know some people don't eat meat. What would you do in its place? Or what would you add or take out? And yeah, if you want to know how I fix my beef, I made a video about that already. So, yep, but this is it. Alright guys, thanks so much for tuning in, and I'll see you soon.